Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Today I'm going to show you how to use LM Studio and local language models so you don't need ChatGPT or other paid solutions to create Python scripts for Blender, a very powerful tool for automating tasks in your 3D modeling workflow. In this tutorial, I'll go over the installation process and provide an example use case to get you started. First, go to the LM Studio homepage and download and install the software. After the installation has finished, you need to run LM Studio and choose a language model you want to use. I would suggest you choose a model which is specialized in coding because it will give the best results. You can scroll down and have a look and choose what you want to download. After it finished downloading, go into the chat interface on the left and choose the model you want to load. Let it load up, and when it's finished, we are going to load up Blender and try use case example. When you have loaded a new instance of Blender, we need to adjust the interface so we can test the scripts and save and manage everything. So either you can create a new preset for that, or we can choose a template which is provided here. And now we can go back into LM Studio and start creating the scripts for Blender. Back in LM Studio, we are going to specify what we want to achieve with the script. I have an example here, so I'm going to ask DeepSeek coder, in this case, it should write a Python script for Blender. It should select and delete all scene objects, then add a new camera, add a 3D add 3D cursor position or any other you specify, and reset the rotation of the new camera. This is by design relatively unspecific and very natural language. The more information you provide, the better results you will get. But let's have a look what it's going to do with this instruction, because there can be very specific problems which could occur in this case. For example, positioning of the new camera and so on, if you don't specify it specifically. But we can come to that later. Let's have a look what it's going to do. When it finished generating, double check what it's going to do in the script itself. So it's going to import a BPY, which is an API in Blender specific. So scripting. First, it's going to select all objects as we wanted to. Then it's going to delete selected objects. Afterwards, it's going to create a new camera and position it accordingly with our specified rotation. So now, select the script, copy it, and now we are going to take this into Blender to test it out. So now, inside of Blender, we are going to click on New to create a new script. Name it accordingly, so maybe 2D setup, camera, only roughly what it's going to do. Obviously, you're going to need to think about how you name it appropriately, and we are going to paste the text. We have a look if everything is correct. If the text is correctly indented. If you have indents at the start, it's going to give an error that an unexpected indentation is found. Since Python is indentation sensitive, you need to be careful about that. But it looks fine. So now we are going to save it somewhere appropriately. And either you are going to run the script, or you can go in and choose the console. And here you are going to see what's happening in the 3D scene. You're going to execute a script. So now I'm going to click into the console and paste or a script to be sure, copy inside this text format and paste it into the console. And as you can see, it automatically executed those steps and it deleted the cube, created our camera, reset the rotation accordingly. And since that's working, you can now save it and begin another thing. Very, very useful. So I would suggest trying this out for yourself. And since you don't need to invest any money or have any costs, this is a very good solution to my mind. But before you finish, I'm going to show you something else. An example how you need to be careful with this. Here in LM Studio, I have another chat conversation. And since there are many different models and variants, the one thing is better in some than the other. This one was Code Llama, for example. And it gave me somewhat weird solution for the script. And as you can see, it specified the object rotation manually. No problem in that. But as you can see above, it strangely enough deselects all objects and then deletes everything, which is the opposite we want. So if you realize this, at least in the end in Blender, you need to read over the script. Normally it's commented by the language model itself what it's doing. And when you recognize these mistakes, either ask the language model itself to redo or specify the error by yourself or correct it manually, since it's quite obviously you can just by yourself delete, deselect and write select by yourself. It's up to you. Since it's a free solution for many different things like ChatGPT or add-ons, which are normally costly, I guess this is a very good solution for someone who isn't very versatile in coding, but want to leverage the ease of these scripts without much of an expertise on that level. Hopefully this was useful for you. I will see you in the next tutorial. Have a good day.